Hello, it's Jang here with a look at a classic LEGO space set called the Surface Hopper. This came with 23 pieces in 1985. And I'm pretty fortunate to get my hands on one of these in a pretty, very, very good shape, actually, except for the face on the figure. Surface Hopper, so this is, well, you can pretty much see how the name comes into it, because the idea is that this thing would be hopping around the surface of some unexplored planet. It's got all the little thrusters on the bottom that would cause it to go up in the air, and you got the little rockets on the back. So it's not a spaceship, it's just a thing for traveling around the surface of the planet. So it's kind of like a lander, except it's not intended to land, it's intended to just go from one point on the land to another, kind of like this. You know, just little short little trips, little scouting kind of runs and stuff. I like these old hoses in a translucent yellow with the transparent ends. And he's got a little scanner device in his hand is what that's being used for there. I don't know what the green dish on the back is supposed to be. I don't know what that's all about. It's probably not related to propulsion in any way. It's probably more related to something about scanning or radar or, I don't know, maybe, I just don't know. I really don't know. Take the figure off and you see that this is really just a little rocket chair, you know? It's just such a simple thing, such a simple concept. And this was a cheap set, so it wasn't intended to try to impress you too much, but I think it does a pretty good job for what it is. The space guy himself, the minifigure, has a good torso on him, but the face is a little bit worn down, you know? Just doesn't quite have that same full smile. Kind of looks just a little bit like some of the life is missing. So that's unfortunate. It's good that the figure was actually played with over the past 30 years. It wasn't just sat in some collector's hermetically sealed case or something. But I still think that the face itself just looks a little bit sad on this one. Everything else is in pretty good shape. Some scuffs and stuff, but yeah, no big deal. And 1985, this was during a time when it was appropriate for the thicker chin strap to be around. So this may be an actual proper original. Sometimes, well, very frequently, folks tend to mix up the different parts, especially helmets and stuff over time. And, you know, collections that have parts from different eras will just get, yeah, combined together. And there's nothing wrong with that. But I feel like I got pretty lucky with this one. And it's pretty authentic. So, hey, there's not much else to say about this set. If you would like to say anything about it, please feel free to down in the comment section. And I've got a lot more videos to bring you. So I'll be talking to you again very soon. Bye for now.